Hello, my friends. Today we will revise some important rules and some problems in calculus. First important rules, v of h equal f of x plus h minus f of x, which is variation. Second rule is a of h equal v of h over h equal f of x plus h minus f of x over h, which is average rate of change. Rate of change equal limit f of x plus h minus f of x over h when h tends to 0. Equal limit a of h when h tends to 0. And now we have some derivatives like sine x, its derivative is cosine x. Cosine x, its derivative is negative sine x. Tan x, its derivative equal sec square x. And we have also chain rule. Chain rule equal means dy by dx equal dy by dz times dz by dx. Okay? We have also all the rules like area of square equal s power 2, and when we use it in variation problems, change it by f of x equal x power 2. Area of rectangle equal length times width. For example, if length exceed 2 more than width, you can suppose that l equal x plus 2 and w equal x, so area equal x plus 2 times x, which equal x power 2 plus 2x. When you use it in the variation problem, you can use it as f of x equal x power 2 plus 2x. Area of trapezium equal half times sum of two parallel bases times height. Area of circle equal pi r power 2 equal 22 over 7 x power 2 when we use it in variation problem. Area of triangle equal half base times height. Okay. Lateral surface area of a cube equal 4 s power 2, where s is the side of the cube or the edge length of the cube. When you use it in variation problems, f of x equal 4x power 2. Total area 6s power 2, f of x equal 6x power 2. Volume of cube is s power 3, so f of x equal x power 3. Equation of line, y minus y1 equal m times x minus x1, where m is the slope and x1, y1 is a point on the line. Solved examples to illustrate this. If f of x equal x power 2 plus 3x, find the average rate of change when x varies from 2 to 2.3 and the rate of change at x equal 2. First, we have f of x equal x power 2 plus 3x. Try to find f of x plus h. Substitute x by x plus h. X plus h equal to the power 2 plus 3 times x plus h. And you can expand this to get x power 2 plus 2xh plus h power 2 plus 3x plus h plus 3h. Then find v of h, which is variation, equal f of x plus h minus f of x. If you subtract this from this, x power 2 cancelled with x power 2, and 3x cancelled with 3x, and you will have 2x plus 2xh plus h power 2 plus 3h. A of h equal v of h over h. So divide this over h. Okay? You will get 2x plus h plus 3. When x equal 2, and x changes from 2 to 2.3, so subtract 2 from 2.3 to get 0.3, which is h. So a of 0.3, you can substitute 2 instead of x and 0.3 instead of h to get 7.3. Okay. Rate of change equal limit a of h when h tends to 0. So limit 2x plus h plus 3, which is a of h, when h tends to 0. We have x equal 2 and h equal 0, so 2 times 2 plus 0 times 3 plus 3 equal 7. Another example, if f of x equal root x, find the rate of change at x equal 4. First, f of x equal root x, you must change it to x power half. F of x plus h means x plus h equal x plus h equal to the power half. V of h means subtract this from this, so x plus h all to the power half minus x power half. A of h means divide v of h by h. You will have that. Rate of change, take the limit when h tends to 0. We know from limits that we can add x from here and subtract x from here. So it will be like this, and you can use your rule to find the answer. Divide power by power, half divided 1. Take 1x and subtract powers, half minus 1, you will get half x power negative half, half 1 over 2, x power negative half is equal root x, but in the denominator, because the negative sign. So you have equal 1 over 2 root x. Substitute now by x equal 4. So 1 over 2 times root 4 equal 1 over 4. Another example. A child threw a stone in a pool of water. It made circular waves. Find the rate of change of area of the circular wave. So he want the rate of change of the area of circular wave. So he want the area of circle. Area of circle equal pi r bar 2. 22 over 7 r bar 2. Change the area to be f of x equal 22 over 7 x bar 2. Now f of x plus h 22 over 7 x plus h all to the power 2. V of h subtract this from this. A of h divide by h. Then you will reach to the rate of change 22 over 7, you can take it as a common factor. Limit x plus h power 2 minus x power 2 over h. And you can add x and subtract x and do like the previous problem to find the rate of change and then substitute the radius of the circular wave means here x. So substitute 14 instead of x, you will get 88. Another problem. Discuss the continuity and differentiability of the function f of x equal x power 2 plus 3 when x greater than or equal 1 and 3x plus 1 when x less than 1 at x equal 1. Now, we can take the limit from right, which is x power 2 plus 3, substitute 1 instead of x, you will get 4. The limit, the left limit, 3x plus 1 when x less than 1, the left limit when x less than 1. So, 3x plus 1, and you can substitute to get 4. Now, the right limit equal the left limit, so the limit exists, and equal. So, f of 1, try to get f of 1. F of 1, when x greater than or equal 1, do substitution with 1, 1 power 2 plus 3 will get 4. Limit f of x equal f of 1. So, when limit f of x equal f of 1, so the function is e, is continuous. Now we want to discuss the differentiability. Differentiability, you must find limit f of x plus h minus f of x over h when h tends to 0 positive. 0 positive means from right, okay? You can substitute f of x plus h. You have f of x equal x power 2 plus 3. So put x plus h instead of each x plus h equal to the power 2 plus 3 minus f of x, which is x power 2 plus 3. So you can expand and you will get limit to x plus h. Now put h equal 0 and x equal 1, you will get 2. By the same way, we can find the left derivative or limit f of x plus h minus f of x over h when h tends to 0 negative and subtract, you will get 3. So the two limits are different, doesn't equal. So the function f of x is not differentiable at x equal 1. Finished. Another example. If the function f of x equal x absolute value of x plus 3bx plus 3, x greater than or equal 0, ax power 2 plus 2ax plus 3x over x less than 0 is differentiable. He said that the function is differentiable at x equal 0. Find the values of a and b. Since the function is differentiable, so the limit exists. So you can find the limit from right and the limit from left and equal them to get a equal 0. After that, since the function is also differentiable, the right derivative equal left derivative. How can I find the derivative? X power 2 plus 3bx. X power 2, 2 times 1 equal 2, and put x and reduce the power by 1 to be 2x. 3bx, cancel x, it will be 3b. 3 is constant, so its derivative equals 0, so it cancelled. Equal the left derivative, ax will be a, cancel x, 2a is constant, will be 0, 3 will be 0. So you can solve this equation to find b equal 0. Another example, find dy by dx for each of the following curves. Y equal 3x power 4 minus 2x power 3 plus cubic root x power 2 minus 1 over x power 2 plus 5. How can I find the derivative? multiply the power by the coefficient. 3 times 4 equal 12. Write x and reduce it by 1, the power by 1, it will be 3. And so on, 3 times 2, 6, x power 2. Cubic root x power 2, we can transform it to x power 2 over 3, x power 2 over 3. 2 over 3 times 1 equal 2 over 3, write x and reduce the power by 1, it will be negative 1 over 3. X power 2, 1 over x power 2 can be transformed to, x power negative 2, 1 over x power negative 2, can be to x power negative 2. Now, you can, negative 2 times 1, negative 2 times negative 1 equal positive 2, x power negative 3, You can transform your problem, 12x power 3 minus 6x power 2 over 2, this is cubic root of x, but in the denominator, 2x power negative 3 will be 2 over 2 over x power 3, okay? Excuse me. Y equal to x power 3 plus 2x plus 5 times 2x, 3x minus 2. These are two functions. We multiply them, or the product of two functions. When you differentiate it, or find the first derivative, find the derivative for the first function. It will be 6x power 2 plus 2. And put the second function as it is, 3x minus 2. Then put the first function as it is, and derivative of the second function, it will be 3. You can, after that, expand these brackets and collect like terms. Then, he said that add x equal 1. You can substitute in the final step by x equal 1 to get the answer 35. Y equal 2x power 3 plus 2x plus 5 over 3x minus 2. You have a numerator and denominator. You can find the derivative of the numerator, 3 times 2, 6, x power 2, plus 2, and let the denominator as it is, and derivative, let the denominator as it is, and find the derivative of the denominator. It will be 3. Then you can expand the numerator, and you can expand the denominator, or let it like it is. Another example, y equals sine power 2, 3x. Sine power 2, 3x means sine 3x all to the power 2. So you have a bracket. When you have a bracket, multiply the power by the coefficient outside the bracket, 2 times 1 equal 2. Write the bracket as it is. It will be sine 3x power 1. Then find the derivative of inside the bracket. It will be 3 cosine 3x. Sine 3x equal cosine 3x, it's a derivative of cosine 3x, and put the coefficient outside cosine. And then you can expand this. He said at x equal pi over 2, pi over 2, pi equal 180, divided 2 equal 90, you can substitute with 90 to get the answer 0. Y equal to x cosine 4x. You have a product of two functions, 2x and cosine 4x. So derivative of the first, it will be 2, and let the second, cosine 4x, then let the first and find derivative 2, the second, it will be negative 4 sine 4x. Cosine 4x equal negative sine 4x, and the derivative of 4x is 4, put it here. Then you can simplify it. Y equal to x over tan 3x. You can find the derivative of numerator, it will be 2, and put the denominator, then put the numerator and find the derivative of numerator, it will be 3 square 3x, and you can simplify it. Y equal 3 times 4x minus 2 all to the power 5. You can multiply 5 times 3 equal 15, put the bracket, 4x minus 2, and reduce the power by 1, 4, then find the derivative inside the bracket. 4x, it will be 4, and 2 is will be 0, okay? You can multiply 15 times 4 equal 60, and put the bracket by power 4. Y equal square root, fifth root of 5x plus 2 all to the power 2. You can change it to 5x plus 2 all to the power 2 over 5, in over out. So you have here 1. Multiply the power by the coefficient, and then write the bracket and reduce the power by 1, and then find the derivative of the derivative inside the bracket. It will be 5. You can simplify it, 5 times 2 over 5, and you can transform it. The final answer will be like this. You can transform it to 2 over 5th root over 5x plus 2 all to the power 3 in the denominator because it has negative sign. If y equals z power 2 plus z, z equals 3x, find dy by dx. You can use a chain rule. First, y equals z power 2 plus z, so you can find dy by dz. It will be 2z plus 1. Now, z equals 3x, so you can substitute instead of z by 3x, it will be 6x plus 1. Now, z equals 3x, find the derivative of z with respect to x, it will be 3. Now, using a chain rule said dy by dx equal dy over dz times dz over dx. You can substitute from these rules 6x plus 1 times 3, and you can expand it to get 18x plus 3. If f of x equal ax power 3 plus bx, f of 2 equal 24, and f dash of 2 equal 28, find the values of a and b. What is the meaning of f of 2 equal 24? You can substitute with 2 in the function f of x. So a 2 power 3 b times 2 equal 24, and you can find the equation, simplify this equation to will be 4a plus b equal 12. F dash of 2 equal 28 means find the first derivative first. So 3 times a equal 3a x power 2 plus bx will be, then let it equal 28, and you can find another equation. You can solve these two equations by your calculator, mod 5 1, or by subtracting, and you can find a and find b. Y equal x power 2 plus 3 and z, and x equals z power 4 plus 5. Prove that 3dy by dz minus 2z dx by dz equal 24z by power 7 plus 112z power 3. You can use chain rule also. First, find dy by dx, like the previous problem, and then dx by dz. Dy by dz will equal dy by dx times dx by dz. Note that dx like dx. Okay, and you can substitute dy by dz, you can find dy by dz. After you find dy by dz and dx by dz, you can substitute in the left hand side 3 times dy by dz minus 2z times 4z power 3, and you can expand the brackets and simplify to find the result equal the right hand side. Okay, y power 4 equal 5x power 2 minus 3. We must get y, so take the 4th root for both sides. So y equal 4th root of 5x power 2 minus 3. 5x power 2 minus 3, we can transform this to 5x power 2 minus 3 all to the power 1 over 4. And then we can find the first derivative like the previous problems. 1 over 4 times 1, and put the bracket and reduce the power by 1. Then find the derivative of inside the bracket, it will be 10x, and you can simplify it. Find the slope of the tangent of the curve. Slope of the tangent of the curve means you must find the first derivative. Slope equal the first derivative. So 3 times 1 equal 3x power 2. 2 times 4 equal 8x. 2x, x will be cancelled, and the negative 1 will be 0. So this is the slope. At the point 1 and 2. The point 1 and 2, that means x, and this is y. We need x. At x equal 1, put 1 instead of x, you will get the answer negative 3. So the slope will be negative 3. If he said, find the measure of angle, the same solution like the slope, the same solution, okay, and substitute with 1, the answer will be negative 3. But we have additional step. Additional step, the angle equal 10 negative 1 dy by dx. So angle equal 10 negative 1 of negative 3, you can find it with your calculator, to be 108 degrees, 26 minutes, 5 seconds. Find the equation of the tangent. The same solution you can find. So the first step, you must find the derivative of the curve, dy by dx, and you can substitute by the point x equal 1. You will have the slope. You will have the slope negative 3. So the slope m equal negative 3. The equation of tangent equal y minus y1, m x minus x1, m is the slope negative 3, x1 and y1 are belong to the point 1 and 2. So this is x1 and this is y1. You can substitute and expand to get the equation like this. Okay? Find the points on the curve. You must find the derivative on the curve y equal x power 3 minus 4 x power 2 plus 2x minus 1, at which the tangent is parallel to the line. So you must find the derivative of the curve. It will be the slope of the tangent, like this, and slope of given line, negative coefficient of x over coefficient of y, it will be 2 over 3. If he said perpendicular, you can take coefficient of y over coefficient of x. It will be negative 3 over 2. Since the tangent is parallel to the line, so equal slopes, this is slope, equal this is slope, and you can solve the equation by multiply by 3, by multiplying 3, and then you can find the answers with your calculator, mod 5.3, then substitute with x in the original curve to get y. When you get y, so you have the point, this x has a y and this x has a y, you will get the points 2.4 and negative 5.4 and 0.17 and negative 0.8. Finished. Please try to solve these problems yourself and study them to get high marks. Okay? You can ask me anytime with my best wishes. I want to see your comments. Thanks a lot.